Good evening friends. So all set? All set. Now the date has been announced. We will be having NEET on 6th January 2019. So I am sure that the preparations are now going in full swing. Some sort of anxiety also must be there. So we will be talking about the images that are very frequently asked in the NEET exam. Alright, so starting with the very basic images. So in the NEET exam from the radiology we get very simple and specific questions. One question is that they will give you an image and they will simply ask you the name of the investigation. They may ask you whether it is a CT scan, whether it is an MRI, which sequence of MRI or some other investigations like a contrast study. So we will try to cover them. Then they will ask about the questions on radio anatomy, where a radiological image will be given and an anatomical structure will be marked. So let us start with them. So the first image is, there are three images for you and I hope that all of you can easily identify that this is a transverse section or an axial section, whereas this is a coronal section and this is a sagittal section. Transverse section, coronal section and sagittal section. Okay. Now if you see this image, the first question is whether these images are CT or MR. So please remember, the easiest way to differentiate a CT from an MR is to look at the cortical bone. If the cortical bone is white, it is CT. If the cortical bone is black, it is MR. So look at this whitish structure that you could see here. Now please do not confuse it with the bone, that is a scalp. That is not the bone, that is a scalp. This is bone, and if this is bone, this has to be an MR. So this is an MRI image, this is an MRI image and this is an MRI image. All three are MR images. But now point to be noted is, which sequences of MRI are they? Okay, which sequences of MRI are they, that we will be seeing in a minute. Okay, but I hope all of you can identify that these three are MRI images, because the cortical bone is black and you know that this is an axial section, this is a coronal section and this is a sagittal section. Okay, so there is no DRP in these sessions. If you have a doubt, just put your doubt on the DBMCI premier group and tag my name or tag radiology, and that will be answered. Okay. Now let us look at these images. I hope all of you can identify them, that they all are MRI images. MR, 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 MR. Okay. But there is a difference. All are transfer sections. Again, I hope all of you can identify. But the level at which the section is taken is different, and that will be discussing it in a while. Okay. So this is an MR image. I hope that you can easily identify them. Again, I do not want you to confuse it with the scalp. That scalp, that is cortical bone. Okay. This section is different, this section is different, this section is different, this section is different and this section is different. So what is the difference between these sections? Now let us learn that. This is one image and this is the corresponding image of the same patient. Okay. I hope you can easily identify that this is a transverse section and this is a sagittal section. But the point is, I hope you can see this yellow line. This yellow line tells you at what point the section has been taken, at what level the section has been taken. I hope all of you can see this structure, and this is the corpus callosum. This structure is corpus callosum, and I hope all of you know that the below the corpus callosum there should be lateral ventricle. Below the corpus callosum there should be lateral ventricle. Now point to be noted is, this is above the corpus callosum, so that is it has to be above the ventricle. So this is supraventricular level. This is supraventricular level. Now my point is that if you want to identify the radioanatomy, these are free 10 marks for you in the exam. If you want to identify this, you have to make sure that you are looking at this image and your brain can process this image. They cannot ask too much anatomy in this. The only thing that they may ask you is what is this. So you say obviously this is brain parenchyma and this is cerebral hemisphere. Cerebral hemisphere, there is nothing great into this, okay. But please remember, in MR this side will be right and this side will be left, okay. So this is the midline, this is the midline, this side will be right and this side will be left. In the transverse section, this will be anterior and this will be posterior, okay. On the other hand, in a sagittal section, this will be superior, this will be inferior, this will be anterior and this will be, and this side will be posterior, okay. So anteroposterior, right left, superior inferior is one thing that everybody should be able to identify in the scan without any doubt, okay. Now let us talk about what are the structures that they actually ask. Now let us see this image. In this image, the question that they may ask you is that they will give you this image and you know that this is at the level of lateral ventricle, at the level of, I hope you can easily appreciate that these white color structures are lateral ventricle. Now the question that they usually ask in the paper like NEET is they will give you this image and they will ask you what is the appearance of CSF in this image, what is the appearance of CSF in this image known as. So this is MRI, and please remember, if it is MRI, the terminology will always be intense. If it is MRI, the terminology will always be intense. If it is white, it is hyper. If it is black, it is hypo. If it is black, it is hypo. If it is white, it is hyper. It is an MRI, CSF is white, combining the two, it is hyper intense. Had it been CT, the terminology would have been dense, but because it is an MRI, it is hyper intense, okay. Now let us see this image. Now the common question that we get is on this. This is one of the most frequently asked image in the exam. Now you see this structure. Now this structure is caudate nucleus. This structure is caudate nucleus. Now the other question that you may get in the exam on this is that atrophy of caudate nucleus is a feature of Huntington's chorea. Atrophy of caudate nucleus is a feature of Huntington's chorea, and this is called as boxcar ventricle. Atrophy of the caudate nucleus is a feature of Huntington's chorea, and this is called as boxcar ventricle, whereas this structure is lentiform nucleus. This structure is lentiform nucleus, which has got a peripheral part which is putamen and a medial part which is globus pallidus. Globus pallidus, okay. If you have a difficulty in remembering, please remember it as P for peripheral, P for putamen, P for peripheral and P for putamen, okay. And then you have got this structure which is thalamus, okay. Now putamen, the question that you may get in the exam on the putamen is that putamen is the most common site of hypertensive bleed. Putamen is the most common site of hypertensive bleed, okay. Globus pallidus, there is a disease which involves globus pallidus. There are many diseases, but one disease which is very very categorically asked in the exam is that when there is an iron deposition in bilateral globus pallidus, and that is called as halo Worden Spats disease. Hello Worden Spats disease, and this is called as eye of tiger appearance. Eye of tiger appearance seen in Hello Worden Spats disease. Okay, thalamus. Thalamus, the question that you may get is bilateral hyper intense thalamus. Bilateral hyper intense thalamus. Please remember, it can be seen in many diseases. If the patient has an infection, the most likely diagnosis is Japanese encephalitis. Most common infection, encephalitis, in which there is a thalamic and brainstem involvement, is Japanese encephalitis. Okay. Then lateral to the lentiform nucleus, you see a band kind of structure. You have a band kind of structure here also. So this band, which is between, which is internal to the lentiform nucleus, is called as internal capsule, and the one that is external to the lentiform nucleus is called as external capsule. Okay. And then you have got gray matter here. Here, this gray matter lined track is called as insula. Insula. Please remember, any of them can be asked in the exam, and all of you should be able to pick up them without any doubt. These are free five marks in the exam, 4 for the correct and 1 for the wrong. Okay. Now let's see this image. Now the idea of showing you this particular image is you have to keep seeing the section here. So this is almost at the level of midbrain. So that means this structure is midbrain. This structure is midbrain. And anybody who can think of, if I'll just show you another image here, is now you can see this white area. Let me just remove the ink for the time being, and then let's try to pick them up. Okay, so basically this is the midbrain, and you can see this, let me change the color, this white structure here, and that's a CSF space. And if you see the CSF space around the midbrain, then this has to be quadrigeminal plate cistern or a perimesenchymic cistern. Quadrigeminal plate cistern or a perimesenchymic cistern. Okay, now let's see this image. If you see this particular image, the common structure that you may get in this particular image is easy one, which is this, which is nothing but the optic nerve, or these muscles, which is lateral rectus, and this muscle, which is medial rectus, lateral rectus or medial rectus. Okay. Whereas if you see this structure, this is, you have started reaching to the level of pons. I hope it is pretty easy for you to appreciate on the basis of this image here. Now the idea is, let's see this point. They will ask, they will mark this structure, and they will ask you what is this structure. Okay. Now point is, this is the pons, and you have a CSF space anterior to the pons. So if you have got a CSF space anterior to the pons, it is called as prepontine cistern. I am writing it here, prepontine cistern. Okay. And it is an anatomy question, that which vessel passes through the prepontine cistern? Basilar artery. So this black color structure that you could see is the basilar artery. Black color structure that you could see is the basilar artery. Very easy, very important, all of you should know without any doubt. Okay. All right. Now let's see a downer image. Now I feel that this may be asked from you in the exam. Now if you see this image, now the point to be noted is, I hope all of you can appreciate that this is the pontomedullary junction, okay. So this is the pontomedullary junction, and just posterior to the pontomedullary junction, this white white structure that you could see is the fourth ventricle. I hope it is again very easy to identify. And this entire thing that you could see is the cerebellum. Is the cerebellum, okay. On the other hand, now if you see this structure, this is slightly difficult one. If you see this structure, anybody who can tell me what is this structure? Now, if you see this, it is on either side here also. This is internal ear and this is brainstem. There is something coming from the brainstem and going towards the internal ear. So this has to be 7th, 8th nerve complex. 7th, 8th nerve complex, okay. Now the question that you may get in the exam from this 7th, 8th nerve complex, now you may get a range of questions, but the common question that I expect that may be asked in the exam related to this image is, they may make a tumor here which is going into the internal canal like this, and this is what is called as vestibular schwannoma or acoustic schwannoma, and this appearance has been described as ice cream cone appearance, ice cream cone appearance, okay. So these are the points that all of you need to remember regarding these images. These are very very simple images, but you should be able to pick them up without any doubt, okay. Brain, these are the common images. Most of the time nowadays what we are getting is a chest image in the exam, and all of you should be able to pick up those chest images. So I hope all of you can easily appreciate that this is a chest image. Again, that's a transverse section and that's a coronal section. Again, I am emphasizing on the same point that this transverse section is taken at this level. Please identify these levels. If you are able to identify this level, then half of the problem of solving an anatomy question is over. Half of the problem is over, okay. Now point to be noted here is, now let's see this image. Now the thing that are happening is, let me just figure it out and let me just make an image for you. Now we know that heart is almost here, okay, and aorta is like this. Aorta goes like this, we all know that, and the arch vessels are like this. So that means if you are taking a cross section here, then means you will not see the aorta, you will see the branch of the arch. On the other hand, if you will take a cross section here, you will see the arch. If you will take a cross section here, you will see the ascending and descending aorta, and if you will take a cross section here, you will see the heart, okay. So the idea is that if you are seeing a transverse image of the chest, your brain should be able to identify whether you are taking the section at level number 1, 2, 3 or 4, okay. So this, how will you identify that? So two things will help you. One is, look at the scapula. If you see the angle of the scapula, if you look at the spine of the scapula, that means you are looking at a higher part or the upper part of the scapula, which will be at D1, D2, okay. If you are seeing the lower end of the scapula, that means you are at the down, okay. Second important structure that will help you is this structure. Now this black structure that you could see in the center of the mediastinum has to be trachea, and if you are seeing the trachea, that means you are above the bifurcation of the trachea, okay. At the level of the bifurcation, we have got aortic arch, or aortic arch is isolated just above the bifurcation, just above the bifurcation, okay. So these three structures that we could see are basically the vessels. So that's brachiocephalic trunk, that's left common carotid, and that's subclavian artery. Brachiocephalic trunk, common carotid, and subclavian artery. These are the three important vessels that we are seeing here, whereas this a slightly bigger vessel that you could see is the SVC, superior vena cava. These are very, very frequently asked images in the exam, and I'm sure that you will be able to get the plus 4 out of this question. Okay. Now, one small doubt here is that I have seen that you may have is whether it's a non-contrast CT or a contrast enhanced CT. Okay. So the commonest mistake that most of us will do it in an image based question is you will try to look at the vessel and you will compare it with the bone. Please don't do that. Don't compare the bone with the vessel. In order to identify a non-contrast from a contrast enhanced CT, always compare the vessel with the muscle. Always compare vessel with the muscle. If vessel and muscle are of same color, it's a non-contrast CT. If the vessel is white than the muscle, then it's a contrast enhanced CT. If the vessel and muscle are of same color, it's a non-contrast CT. If the vessel is white than the muscle, then it's a contrast enhanced CT. Okay. Now let's see this image. Now that's the same image which was asked in this year DNB exam. This structure was marked. See, you have gone slightly down, and this is aortic arch. This is aortic arch, whereas this structure is again superior vena cava. This is aortic arch, and this structure is superior vena cava. Let's go further down. This is one of the most commonly asked image, has been asked thrice in the last two exams. I have gone more down. This structure is ascending aorta. This structure is descending aorta. This structure is pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery. Now, point to be noted that most of the students are unable to identify these radioanatomies, and that is why I am discussing it in this that great detail, because these are free 5 marks in the exam, plus 4 for the correct and minus 1 for the right, minus 1 for the wrong. The point to be noted is that the questions that you may get from this in the exam is which were asked rather last year in the NEET and in AIIMS is there was a filling defect in this vessel, and what is the diagnosis? There is a filling defect in the pulmonary artery, and hence the diagnosis has to be pulmonary thromboembolism. Okay. Or there might be a flap kind of structure in this vessel. If there is a flap kind of structure in the aorta, then your diagnosis is aortic dissection. Aortic dissection. Now, immediately you should know if it is a type A aortic dissection or a type B aortic dissection. So, I think we all know that if the ascending aorta is involved, it is a type A aortic dissection. If the ascending aorta is not involved, that is a type B aortic dissection. It is important to know, because type A aortic dissection is a surgical emergency and type B aortic dissection is not. So, if there is a flap in this vessel, that is a surgical emergency, which was this year May AIIMS MCQ. Okay. And the last year NEET MCQ was this, which is a type B aortic dissection. Okay. Let us go further down. So, if you go further down, these are the images, and this is right ventricle. We have reached to the level of the heart. And this is left ventricle, this is right atrium, and this is left atrium. Okay. So, these are the four chambers of the heart. Now, the take home message is you could see that this is the posterior most chamber of the heart, and if it is the posterior most chamber of the heart and you do a trans esophageal echocardiography, left atrium will be very well seen. Left atrium will be very well seen. Is it okay? All right. Let's go further down, and let's reach to the abdomen. So in most of the previous years, what I have seen is that they will be giving you two radioanatomy questions, one from neuro, one from chest, or one from abdomen. So basically among these three, there will be two that will be asked in the exam. So we have covered neuro, we have covered chest, now let us talk about the abdomen. So I hope all of you can easily appreciate. Now one thing in the abdomen that you need to remember is, see in the chest either it will be a non-contrast CT or it will be a contrast enhanced CT, where the contrast is given through the vascular route. If you will give contrast through the vascular route, the vessel will become white. In the abdomen, you may ask the patient to drink contrast or you may inject. Once you will inject, the vessel will be white. Once you will ask the patient to drink contrast, the bowel will be white, the intestines will be white. Okay. So you may get a question on oral contrast and IV contrast. For IV contrast, look at the blood vessels. For oral contrast, look at the bowel loops. For example, in this image, look at these structures. And what are these structures? These are bowel loops. And if the bowel loops are white, that means oral contrast is given. Whereas what is this structure? That's aorta. Compare it with the muscle. Aorta is also white. So this is oral and IV contrast. Oral and IV contrast. Okay. And this is abdominal aorta. Whereas this structure is intrahepatic IVC. Intrahepatic IVC. Whereas this structure is liver, and this structure is spleen. Okay, this structure is spleen. Okay, this is intrahepatic IVC, this is liver, and this structure is spleen. On the other hand, what is this? Just give me a sec.